What's up, everyone? How's it going? Matt Layton, Shawn Battle. Hey, today we're touching on a few different topics about the Arlington real estate market. Guys, the first headline that you have to know, this is actually incredible. So Urban Turf did a study, and because of Amazon, this is, did you hear about this?
Just when you told me.
So there is a 633% increase in home sales in Pentagon City and in Crystal City, just because of Amazon. It's incredible.
Is that year over year?
So that is year over year from November of 2017 to November of 2018. I'm looking at the report right now. So last year at this time, we had 3 properties that were under contract.
It's pretty low.
This year, we have 22 properties that are under contract. That's a 633% increase. That's like insane.
That's huge.
This is supposed to be the slowest time of the year, but you know, Urban Turf is reporting, and we're seeing it now, that there is this huge 600% market increase, all because of out-of-town investors, people that are in town that want to buy property. So it's nuts.
Yeah, I really think that's what it is. And for us as well, I mean, we have this week 4 closings between Matt and I. For December, a week, 4 closings, that's really high for us. Usually December is slow. We're seeing huge, you know, increases in activity. So to give you an example, I just put a property on Thursday.
Yeah.
In Clarendon Courthouse area, and it went on Thursday. I had 25 agents show it from Thursday through Sunday. 25 different agents. I mean, that's a ton of showings. For December, that's crazy. For spring market, that's amazing.
Yeah.
For December, it's unheard of. So I feel like what we're talking about is maybe that price point in condos under that 500 mark is kind of going nuts. And maybe single families under that 750.
Yeah.
I've seen, like in my neighborhood where I live, they're going crazy. So, I mean, there's certain pockets of certain listings that are really jumping off the market and getting a lot of activity.
Yeah, certain markets are popping right now, 300 to 500,000 especially.
Yeah, so the one that I have under contract now, so it was listed for $450,000. I sold a similar unit in the same building, a little bit smaller. In the spring market, it took 9 days to sell. I got pretty close to the list within 500 bucks. This one, December, it was priced higher. It's a bigger place, extra half bath, but priced at 450, I had over 30 groups through the open house. I mean, that's crazy. Granted, I marketed it like crazy too, but to have 30 groups in December, like right before Christmas during Hanukkah, I mean, it's crazy.
Yeah.
And ended up getting multiple offers, and it's under contract in 4 days. So that is a big effect, right?
Very strong, very solid end of fall, kind of early winter market. What do you think is going to happen in the next like 2 to 3 weeks?
So next two weeks, I think, honestly, you're not going to see a ton of properties come on the market because it's the holidays. A lot of people are just gone. So if I was talking to my clients right now in the next 2 weeks, I probably wouldn't put it on. I'd wait till January. I think it'll probably be a little slower. Inventory is going to be a little bit low over the next 2 weeks. Once January hits, I think we can say, I believe spring market is January this year.
Yeah. I was talking with a couple buyers, and I sent them over like 1 or 2 properties, and they were like, this one looks great. Can you send like maybe a couple more? And I was like, I don't have a couple more. There's like on the market. There's nothing good that's on the market right now. It's kind of hard to find properties. So I'm like, listen, can you wait like 2 to 3 weeks? Because once January 1st hits, I think that's going to reset a lot of people's mindset. And then that's when the new properties are going to start coming on the market.
Yeah. So I think, you know, waiting till spring, if you're a seller out there and like we always say, hey, wait for that spring market. I think the spring market's going to be early this year. So consider doing it maybe January, February instead of March, April, May, because if you're the first dog on the property or first dog on the market, you're getting all the attention. Yeah. Your bark is louder. But if you're, I don't know where I picked that one up.
I like it.
if you come in late and everybody else is flooding the market, then you're not seeing that you're gonna be flooded too. I mean, so you're not gonna get the value. So
So if you're a seller right now and you're thinking, okay, I know I'm gonna sell my property in 2019. What sorts of things would you be doing now to get the property ready? And when do you want to put it on the market?
So right now you should be getting all your paint done. Get your light bulbs done. I have a listing coming on in Arlington that I'm changing out light fixtures. The seller okayed it. I'm changing out light fixtures because they're horrible. Upgrading the lighting, changing all the bulbs throughout the property. I'm changing the old thermostat to a Nest thermostat. I think it's the little things like that. Yeah. So buyers don't have anything to really...
It's the first thing they notice. They walk in, they see a thermostat from 1987. It's supposed to be like a luxury condo, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
They get caught up on the little things.
They get caught up on the little things. So do the little things right now. Now's your time because over the holidays is a good time to refresh everything. The market's going to start in January. That's my prediction. I think the market's going to start. You're going to see slowly some inventory trickling on, and they're going to jump off the market, especially in... Like I mentioned, the 750 and below for single families, 800 and below, and the 500 and below for condos.
Yeah, so if you're a seller, I mean, do the things, the little things that it takes to prepare to go on the market, because you don't want to rush to go on the market. I mean, when do you want to put it on? Do you want to put it on in January and beat the rush, or do you want to put it on in May and try to see who's left? I mean, what's the ideal?
And the thing with the property that we just got under contract, we were originally considering waiting until next year.
Yeah.
And I said, hey, I think the market's good. Let's try it now. And I was right. I mean, we had a ton of traffic. I hadn't seen that much traffic in a long time. Honestly, one of the best open houses I've done.
Yeah.
If you just went under, or if you just sold. So this is one thing a couple of my clients were saying. Yeah. Like, they were upset that they just settled because they felt like, the market has increased since. Don't feel upset that you just settled. I mean, feel great that you settled. Now you have your cash and now you're ready to buy in the next year. You know, there are some listings that are still sitting there, still languishing. My advice to you is to take the property off the market for maybe the next 2 weeks. If you're not seeing any showings, take it off, refresh it.
Yeah.
Do some new paint, do something new to the property, take some new pictures, change up the pictures, change up the remarks, get something fresh, put a new listing on for the property, and that way it's going to get new attention. If you're just sitting on the market and you're going to wait the next 2 weeks and do nothing, you know, do some action to help yourself in the early spring market of next year, which is January.
Yeah, there's probably not going to be that much activity in the next couple weeks. And so if you've been languishing on the market, maybe take it off. So that's if you're a seller. How about if you're a buyer? I mean, what's how do you prepare for 2019 as a buyer?
So 2019 is going to be, I think, a seller's market.
Still?
I think originally we were thinking it was going to be a buyer's market because we started to see some signs. But I think this whole Amazon effect is real, and it's not Amazon right now. It's the local people that are trying to get in. A lot of my clients are saying, I waited too long, they're freaking out. Don't freak out. You can still get in. You're gonna still see those price increases. The funny thing is, actually at my open house this past weekend was the first time I met our true Amazonian.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
A real Amazonian. They exist.
He said that he wasn't hired because of this. He was actually hired before this news, but he is moving into the area.
Wow.
So it was good to talk to him, take over and drink.
They're out there. Yeah, so as a buyer in 2019, we've done some prediction videos, and I personally don't think the market's going to be as strong from the seller side as 2018. It's still probably going to be a seller's market, but you need to start taking the first couple steps. Get pre-approved. Talk to a local lender. Ben, I see you watching there if you need a local lender. And get ready for a multiple offer situation. So prepare yourself, go out and see properties before the open house, and be sure you're working with an agent.
Nick, you're right. I mean, people are buying things up that no one looked at before. So we're definitely seeing properties that were sitting on the market start to go off. But there's still some there. And why aren't they moving? It's because your price is too high, or you need to do something to the interior. And then you need to entice the buyers in. How are you going to do that? Refresh your listing.
Yeah, I think now's the perfect time just to take a step back, take a deep breath, relax, and get prepared for 2019 because, you know, we had the four closings this week. I mean, some other agents are going to have some closings later this month, but not too much new is going to pop on. The stuff that comes on, I've been seeing some overpriced properties recently, but not too much.
I'm no longer seeing those price increases, which is ridiculous.
Yeah,
And, you know, we got to go back and look to see what happened to those listings.
One of them is still on the market.
Yeah. Wrong thing to do. So get ready for this year. Get pre-approved. You know, the best time for a buyer to buy would be summer months or winter months, but this winter, call it over. Spring's hitting early. Usually I would tell if you were a buyer, wait till August, July, August. But think about what will happen during that time frame, next 6 months. Is it worth it for you to wait until a little bit of a slower time? Or is it worth it for you to jump in, write a strong contract, and get the thing? Because interest rates are rising and the prices are increasing. So if you're waiting 6-7 months to jump in, you might have seen lost out on a big increase and lost out on a good interest rate.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Cool.
That's it. That's short it. One today, but
short one.
We think the market is killer. I think it's going to be an early spring, so get ready.
Yeah.
Get
prepared.
Get out there.
Cool, guys.
Talk to you.
Thanks for watching. Catch you later.